Hello friends, welcome to our channel Global Tech Learn. In today's video, we will see how we can use fuzzy match to merge two queries in Power BI. When we use fuzzy matching option while merging two queries, it looks for the string that approximately matches the pattern for joining instead of performing join operation on the exact match. Please refer video mentioned in the description below to check how merge query option work in Power BI. So let's see in Power BI how we can merge two queries with the fuzzy matching option. As you can see in the Power Query editor, I have employee query which can take column employee ID, employee name and salary. Then there is one more query employee info which contain further information about the employee such as email and phone number. We have to merge these two queries to get a reserve set in a new query. So select employee. Go to the merge query option and select merge query. So let's merge employee with employee info. As you can see in both the queries, employee name is common. So select employee name column in both the queries as a join condition. And from the join type, let's select inner char. Here at the bottom, you can see it showing the selection matches 6 of 10 rows. So let's click on OK. Renaming this query as employee dates. And expand the employee. Let's select all the column from here. So now as you can see in the employee query, 10 records are available. And in employee info also 10 records are available. But in the result set, we got only 6 records. So let's go to the employee query again. Here you can see for the employee with name John, the spelling is given as J-O-H-N. And in employee info, the John is spelled as J-O-N. For employee Emma, the spelling is written as E-N-N-A. Whereas in employee info, it is spelled as E-M-A. So you can see these two values are not exact match, but approximate match. So let's again go to the FYD team and change the join condition. So select the join condition. And here we get the option of use fuzzy matching to perform merge. Click on this. Now you can see it is showing the selection matches 8 out of 10 rows. Click on OK. Go to the expand. You can see we got the information about John and Emma from employee information table, even though the names are not exact match. But still you can see there are 10 employees and in the final result, we got only 8 records. So let's check again in employee. In employee, if we can see for the employee, Alexander and Esapena. And in employee info, Alexander is presented as AX and Esapena, the short form is given as ESA. So there is no match between these two records, but we have to map these names and get the information against Alexander and Esapena. So for that, let's create one mapping table where we are showing AX is represented as Alexander. And ESA is represented as Esapena. Again, go to the employee detail and click the join criteria. Now, in this fuzzy matching option, expand this option. The first is similarity threshold. This defines how similar two values should be in order to get match. If you check the information given here, it is showing that by default the threshold value is 0.80 and we can give the minimum threshold value as 0.00 and the maximum threshold value as 1. If we provide the threshold value as 0.0, then in that case, it will match the records at any level of similarity. And if we provide the threshold value as 1, then it will give us the exact match. Then we have the ignore case option, whether it should be case sensitive or not. Match by combining text path. This option helps to combine text paths which have spaces in between and then match with the join condition. So let's keep these two options as it is. Then there is option of maximum number of matches, which is also optional. By default, it provides all the matches, but if we want, we can provide how many number of matches we want query to return. Then the last option is a transformation table. So now, as you can see in the employee table for the Alexander and Isabella, in employee info, approx match is not present. Instead of that, AX and ESA respectively is given. We want information for these two records also. But you can see in the mapping table, we have provided the mapping value for Alexander and Isabella with the values of AX and ESA. So go to the employee detail and click on the source setting. And in this fuzzy matching option, in the transformation table option, select the mapping table from this list. Now you can see it is giving the selection matches 10 of 10 rows. Click on OK. Expand the employee. So now we got all the 10 records. Here from the employee, the employee name was Alexander, and in the employee info, it is represented as AX. So we have mapped these values and got the record. Similar is the case with the Isabella. So in this way, we can use fuzzy matching option in Power BI to merge two queries. If you find this video useful, then please do like, share and subscribe our channel Global Tech Learn. Also mention in the comment section if you want us to cover any other topic related to Power BI. And we'll be back with more such learning videos. Till then, take care.